Lord, we want to thank you for the table you've prepared for us since yesterday. We thank you for what you're doing here. We thank you for the army that you are raising. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. Tonight, I just request that you speak to us and cause your name to be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody say a good amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. I want to again thank the Lord for the opportunity to be here. And I want to thank God for his servant, Pastor David Ogbele, and his wife, for the heart God has given to them. The Lord pulled me out after some time of working the ministry of intercession and sent me back to school. And when I was about rounding it up, I remember very clearly, about this time last year, he said to me that he has two people he's going to send me to give this thing that you're doing a voice. And he's one of them. That day I called him and I said to him, I want to see you. I didn't know he was no more in Lagos. And he said, come. And we talked. That's a year, about this time last year. And he says, where are you going to today? And I said, well, I'm supposed to be in my church. He said, come. There's something going on in VGC. And that's how we started this journey. This is about the sixth place. I want to pray that the Lord will strengthen you. I know that the heart that you have is a large heart. And the Lord is just going to strengthen you and your wife in the name of Jesus and strengthen Dominion City in Jesus' name. The Lord bless every one of us. And tonight I'm going to walk with you with a slide. Thank God it's already there. I just felt that we should do this today. I know some of us may not have had the first one we had, but from Orchid Hotel, the last Zero Counter we had in Orchid, Zero Counter, yeah, we began to touch this. This is what is very strong in my heart tonight, and I want us to look at it. All right. Let's just, please, can you move the slide? All right. I don't know whether you can see this. Okay. Yeah. So that everyone can see it. We're going to be looking at followership skill development. I want us to look at this introduction, this we serve as a bedrock. I want us to look at it. I want to be sure you can see it. So I would like us to read it together. If you can see it, want to go, Stephen. You can see it. Please, can you do something about it? Can you see it? All right, if you can see, let's go. Let's just read it together. Want to go. Yes. Stop there. Look at what they said. This is a lamentation. These researchers, they conducted the research. This was their findings. They recounted the experience of a follower. This was their finding. They say, when we feel unmotivated, they send our supervisors to class on motivation. Why are they not helping us get the skills we need to stay productive? We are the ones who have the problem, but it is our supervisors, our leaders that are sent for training. I don't know whether you understand what I'm talking about. That was a lamentation. It was a study that was carried out. This is what has been happening for years. So much emphasis has been given to leadership. We've heard so much on leadership skills. We have problems. Why are they not concerned about our own skills, the skills to follow? Why is this thing one-sided? There are skills to lead. I even have a problem now. Treat my problem. But you, for my, you know, there's a way they say, why are you taking Panadol for another person's headache? Have you heard that kind of thing before? That's what you see here. I am the one who have the problem, but it's my supervisor, it's my leader that is going to go for a course of the problem that I have. I don't know whether you are listening to me tonight. So the Lord began to point us to this aspect, the other side. It is called the flip side of leadership, is followership. It's a skill. So sentiments like these, shared by followers, could make them very difficult to manage in an organization or make them unproductive. So it takes two, the leaders and followers, to move a church to the next level, to move any organization to the next level. Focus on me. Help me. You are helping my boss, my leaders. Let's go. So, have you understood that? Let's now look at the concept of what I call the concept of be with me followership skill. Now, notice that that lamentation I earlier showed you in the last slide was about focus on my skill. I am having skills challenge. I want to follow this leader. I want to follow the leader. I want to understand him. That's the issue I have. So there are skills to lead and there are skills to follow. So now we just want to pick one. And that is what I call the be with me followership skill. Everybody say, be with me followership skill. Pastor Dave, you know, he has his way. He has touch. You will soon see. Be with me followership skill. Let's go. That's what we're going to look at just tonight. We're going to look at just only this one. Introduction. This concept examines how followers can employ the be with me followership skill to get all they ought to get from their leader or mentor to become who they ought to be. All right? So the 12 disciples' walk relationship model with Jesus is a typical case in point. Mark chapter 3, verse 13 to 15. Please give us that. Mark 3, verse 13 to 15. Mark chapter 3. Let's look at that concept. The Bible says he goeth up into a mountain and called unto them whom he would, and they came unto him. All right? They came unto him. He called them. They came unto him. And he did what? He ordained 12 that they should. Now, he ordained them. Now, he wants to describe the job, give them job description. One of the first job description was what? That they would do what? That they should be with what? Be with him. That they should be with him. Being with him was like, you know, something that has to be done. Then, the Bible says, and that he might, that's number one. Number two, that he might send them forth to preach. That's number two. All right? Let's move. Number three, and to have power to heal sickness and to cast out all devils. So, the be with me was to precede the other three. If that does not exist, this other three will not work. You understand the transfer he's talking about just now? Do you understand the passing, the release of the grace that he's talking about? Without these other three will not work. Are we still together now? If you don't have this key to stay with the leader God has sent you to, you are wasting your time. Yes, you are wasting your time. All right, let's go back to the slide. Okay, so that's the scope tonight. We're going to look at the scope of be with me skill, drivers be with me, followers skill, the test for be with me scheme to test, are you really staying? Importance and benefits of be with me scheme. Let's move on quickly. Let's move to the next slide. So the Jesus model, the call and expectation, they were called to follow. Jesus identified, invited them. Jesus was the one invited, selected them. He sent an unlikely and undisqualified group of ordinary men to seek the lost. And they were going to proclaim and demonstrate the good news and good works, respectively. This all that he had in mind. Right? But first, stay with me. All right, let's run. Now, notice that obedience, one can see that Jesus was the one who called them. They did not apply for the job to follow and become. He was one who called them. He was one who called them. They didn't run for it. They didn't fight for it. They didn't struggle for it. He was one who called them. Then they obeyed. They obeyed and came to stay. Obedience is critical when we're talking about, you know, if something must leave the leader for you, this has to happen. So they obeyed. All right, that provided a platform. Let's run. Don't want to spend too much time here. They were ordained. Jesus called or appointed the 12 to train them and deploy them for service. Let's run. Let's still run. Move on. That they were called to become fishers of men and left their businesses to follow Jesus all the time. They were required to have a thorough knowledge of Jesus' message and to be able to teach others what they had themselves learned. In essence, they were meant to stay or be with him for this dream to be realized. All right? Let's run. I'm going somewhere. All right? Next slide, please. All right? So why be with me? Why? Jesus had a goal to achieve that was so great that other people would be needed for the task. So he also knew that they needed to be with him enough for him to send them for the task. You need to be there enough to be sent. Enough to be sent. Enough to be sent. You must have been there enough to be sent. All right. Next slide, please. Next slide. All right. You know, I've explained this. Move to the next slide. Let me try and define what be with me skill is. Definition. Be with me followership skill is the staying ability of a follower with a leader that allows the leader with enough time and resources to impart or transfer needed skills for defined organizational or team goals. You must have stayed enough to qualify you and to give him enough time to transfer, to impart and impart the things that he carries and push them into your life. You must have stayed enough. All right. So that's it. Let's go on. So the skill of a follower to be available, be there for full mentorship of the leader, that is what one can refer to as the be with me skill. Available is available. All right? Next slide, please. The follower has to be totally available. Staying with the leader, mentor, should come willingly from the heart. Here, now, I want to explain something to you from this point. I want you to know that there's a difference between being around and following. Hello? There is difference between being around and what? Following. You see, when we are talking about followership precedes discipleship. The Bible says that, follow me and I will what? Make you. I am not talking about discipleship tonight. I'm talking about, you know, you know, when we define the academic circle, when we define followership, it's like the capacity and willingness of, you know, of someone to follow a leader. But you see, in the kingdom, if we want to look at it, in the kingdom, followership is the heart connection between the leader and the follower. In such a way that anywhere the heart of the leader is, that's where the heart, that follower is. So you can be around a leader and your heart is not connected to the leader. You are not following. Go and ask Gehazi now and Elisha. He was around. How do I know? One day, the Oga eventually gave him the rod. He said, go and wake up that dead person. Did the child move? Did the child wake up? Did the dead person wake up? There was no transfer. Gehazi has been around. Gehazi was not following. So nothing left his master for him. Don't forget, in the definition we're talking about, around well enough, and when we're talking about that matter, the last matter, you have to be around to that point. It's not around today. You are not there tomorrow. No. That's what happened to in the case of Judas Iscariot. Maybe initially. But later, there was a disconnect. There was a disconnect. Nothing. It doesn't matter how long you be in church. We were the foundation member. It doesn't mean the motto will automatically be transferred to you. No. It can't work. Followership is a heart connection that allows the leader to pour on the follower. If there is no connection, nothing is living for anybody. It won't work. Say, we are the foundation member. They are not looking at our direction. You want to kill the work? Are they looking for managers? In kingdom business, core ministry, it's not managers they are looking for. No. There was no other person around. Elisha gave him the rod. He said, take this rod. Go and wake up the child. He went there. Nothing happened. Be with me means, okay, you know sometimes how you are talking with somebody, even your wife. After a while, you ask, are you with me? Pastor Dave, have you ever asked your wife before? Is it that you are not seeing her physically? Is she there physically? But what are you looking for? Connection that will allow me pour what I carry. You know, the subject of discipleship is deep. That's not, I'm not nearing there. Oh, that's not where we are going. He said, follow me, that I will do all. So that I will make. If there is no following, there is no what? No making. That is the connection. Where the subject of followership is about connection. Can you be asking somebody who is standing with you physically, are you with me? For Jesus, it was a priority. He said, your day to it, that they might be the very first of this world, be with me. Please, let's run. Then the other one was ability to go through conditions of training. Run, let's run quickly. So be with me, skill precedes discipleship. I've been saying these things. The subject of discipleship is not, you know, it's very broad. All right, let's run. He says, one can only disciple one who is with him. We're talking about disciple. It's somebody that's with you can disciple. Are you listening to me? Yes, he comes to church. He attend pastor's meeting. He attend every kind of thing. But it's not with. It's not with him. One can only disciple or mentor whom one sees. Jesus made it clear that for them to be able to learn all the, he had to teach them, they needed to stay with him, be with him. Let's run. Next slide. Let's look at drivers of be with me followership skill. What are the things that drive it? Number one, realization that one has something to learn. One can make a follower to stay. You look at your lead, there's something I'm supposed to learn. Look at Peter. What Peter needed was breakthrough in Luke chapter 5. But do you know that when the breakthrough came, he looked at the fishes. He looked at Jesus and said, no. This man carries more than the fishes. He left everything and followed. You realize that this one, you know, sometimes there's something I see in the church. You know that this man is loaded. You know this is your pastor. You know that this is your head. You actually know that there are things you are supposed to learn from him, but you are fighting it. How many of you know what I'm talking about? You are fighting it. You are resisting it. You don't want to accept it for some reasons that you have. Next one, quickly. The second one, seeing the leader as the right mentor can also be a motivation to stay. The right mentor. Jesus, at some point, you know, when some people, he began to teach very, you know, tough things, a lot of them left Jesus. They went away. Jesus called the 12 around. He said, are you also going to go? He said, to who? You are the one who, after you, there's no other person. When you know that this is the right mentor, why are you fighting it? Is your mentor, is the one that God, at this point in time, wants you to drop grace from? Why are you fighting that connection? You know, and by the way, the Lord told me tonight, there's something he wants to do. There's a disconnect. Some of us have disconnected. We need to reconnect. Are you listening to me? Otherwise, you are wasting your time. Don't tell me 5 years, 7 years. It means nothing before God. 10 years doesn't mean anything. We started the church. It doesn't mean anything, sir. That there must be a connection. You know, the man who trained me in ministry, he said something to me about 3-4 weeks ago. We're talking, and I had invited him to come and minister. Minister 2 days. He's a loader. He's a very powerful teacher. You know, I was there the last day. I remember the day he brought me memories of the days I used to be with him, Pastor Charles Chowan. Then by the second day, I said, look, this man is going to put me in trouble. Now, we are going to use the same test. Now, the third day, what am I going to share after this first day and second day? Then, so when we're reviewing the message, anyway, God helped me, I finished. We're reviewing the entire meeting. We got talking, and I was telling him about that principle over 20 years ago or so that he used to teach us. He laughed. He said to me, Seth, you know, you can say this. He called this name, called that name. He said, they were with me. They learned nothing. After 20 years, he's telling me they didn't live with anything. He was calling it. Ah, I pray for somebody here. That will not be your story. Yeah. He told me, they didn't learn anything. You know what he told? He went further. He didn't stop. He said, their eyes were after money. Their eyes were after money. Their eyes were after money. So they did not learn anything. He told me, I'm not saying about not up to a month. May that not be your story. May that not be your story. All right, next slide, please. Next slide. Test for the Be With Me followership skill. Is there a connection? How do we know? One of the ways the Be With Me followership skill can be tested is through adverse condition and periods of uncertainty. Adverse condition. When things are not, you know, condition. Adverse conditions seem to be an experience that can assist to test one who has the Be With Me skill. when things are not the way they are supposed to be. Are you listening to me? You see the other people, when they thought there would be bread, when there was no bread, you know, trouble started. And some of them began to leave. Is that okay? Next slide, quickly. Next slide. Let's quickly take a look at that. All right? In the case of the 12 disciples, I've talked about this. They stayed, but the other people, they left. Now, go and check your Bible. Some of those people, they were disciples. Eh? You remember? They were what? Disciple. But it was bread. Somebody say bread. Somebody say bread. Bread has put a lot of people in trouble. Esau. Yes. Next slide. Next slide. What to eat and what to drink. You just sell your destiny. You know that there's something you're supposed to get from this man. But bread. Bread. Because of bread. You have traded the grace that ought to come to you for bread. You didn't give me. You didn't do this. Another example, you know, remember Ruth and Oprah and the Naomi case in Ruth chapter 1? Remember? The woman, Oprah left, but Ruth continued. I'm sure you know how Ruth finished. Eh? There was an adverse condition there. And Ruth said, look, anywhere you die, I'll die. Anywhere you go, you go. Your God will be my God. Now, she wasn't sure what was going to happen on the other side. But she was ready to stay with her mother-in-law. The man God brought over your life, when he's passing through, what do you do? A lot of believers, what they do, they change camps. They move. They move. They're not staying. There's no heart connection. All right, next slide, quickly. Next slide. Joshua had it. You remember? Everybody will go. Joshua, we stay. We still be there waiting. I'm sure you know how Joshua finished. The mantle reached him. Everybody would have gone. Joshua will still be staying. Why Moses is there? Before the law, one thing or the other. Everybody would have gone. Joshua will stay. Even Moses, even his brother, Aaron, will go. This Joshua will do what? Will stay. All right, let's go. Next slide. Importance and benefits of Be With Me followership skill. A follower with a Be With Me skill will likely end up becoming what his mentor or spiritual leader was, or even more prominent. All of these, some of these things Pastor Dave mentioned. Are you listening to me? That's how they end up. They will end up big or better. All right. God told Moses to lay hands on Joshua. I'm sure you know that. You know how Joshua finished. Moses stopped somewhere. Joshua is the one who took them to the promised land. All right. Next slide. Next slide. That of Ruth, you know, her name entered the genealogy of Christ. That's how those who stay, who had a heart connection, that's how they end up. All right, next slide. Elisha had the Be With Me followership skill, had that skill to stay. Even in adverse conditions, he stayed. He stayed. There was a connection. Even the prophets at those three locations, you know, they kept telling him, do you know that your master will be taken away? They knew. The one in Jordan, they also knew. Those ones were 50. They were around, but they were not following. I don't know whether you're listening to me. They were what? Around, and they were not following. Their hearts were not where Elijah was. So the thing dropped only on who? Elisha. I used to say, time I teach on this, just imagine those 50 prophets that were in Jordan. They cross with Elisha to the other side. Do you know? You know, heaven is so blessed. Heaven will have enough resources for all of them. I don't know whether you're hearing me. And they will all collect it and they will cross to Israel. There will be commotion everywhere. Instead of 32, there will be multiple miracle signs and wonder. But they were around and there was no connection. Their heart were not where the national prophet was. So the man gave it, the dose, only to Elisha And he left. May that not be your portion. Next slide. Next slide, quickly. But you also know that on the contrary, that this man, Elijah, had a servant when Jezebel warned him. Remember, in Genesis, in 1 Kings chapter 19, said, by this time tomorrow, I'll take off your head. Do you know what that servant did? He left Elijah. He left him. Till today, he's not known. In advert condition, he left his master. Up to today, you don't even know him. Are you willing to stay? You are connected to the leader, even in advert condition. Today, nobody knows he's forgotten. It's not known. All right, next. Jesus, in his own word, declared that if any man will serve me, let him follow me. And where I am, this where I am is not just physical. This where I am is where my heart is. Let your heart be there. Are we still together? All right. So, here, Jesus made it clear that anyone who serves him should do two things, follow him, and wherever he is, where Jesus is, if you have a leader, a departmental leader, the pastor of your branch, where his heart is, let your heart be there. That's the only way where something can pass to you. All right, next slide. So, one cannot expect to serve, follow, or be mentored without first being where his or her leader is when needed. The follower can then receive honor in return for staying. One can say that honor can come in terms of succession, promotion, skills, and so on. All right? There are many blessings that go with that. Next slide. All right? Let's look at the Be With Me challenge. The challenge of, there is a two challenge I want to just discuss here, then I will close. The challenge of who one choose to be with. Because you see, if you are not with a leader God sent you to, you must be with somebody else. Your heart must be somewhere else. Let's look at John chapter 21, 1 to 4. We read two parts in that same chapter 21, then we'll close. If your heart is not with your leader, your heart must be somewhere else. Are we together now? All right. The Bible says, after these things, Jesus showed himself again to disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. And on this wise showed he himself. All right, verse 2. They were together, Simon Peter. All right, let's all read together. I want to go. Yes. Called Didymus. Yes. 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 All right. You see, this is Peter, the one giving the mandate to. Who is he with? Who is he with? Mention two people there that you know. Thomas called what? Didymus. And what? Nathanael of Cana in Galilee. You know these two people? How many of you know these two people? Okay, let's now see what happened. Let's see what happened. Simon Peter said unto them, I go fishing. After staying with Thomas, what else do you expect Peter to say? Help me ask your neighbor, who have you been staying with? Because if your heart is not with your leader, your heart must be somewhere. Let me ask your neighbor, who have you been following? See, the company, why did he take it away? Bring it back. In the company of Thomas Didymus and Nathanael. You know Nathanael too? Say, can anything good? After fellowshipping with this type of people, what do you expect? Go to the next verse. What did Peter say? I go. Is it not the fishing he left when there was abundance? In Luke 5. Now he's going back to it, leaving the mandate because he has been with Thomas. Listen now. They say unto him, look at it, oh, there was no. Okay. No. They gave no. They must have been telling him, we told you before. You see, this Jesus, we told you. You know, this thing will not work. Then they said to him, we also go with thee. And they went forth and entered into a ship immediately. And that night, they caught. Hear me ask your neighbor, who have you been following? Because if your heart is not with your leader, your heart must be somewhere. You finally discover where Gehazi's heart was when Naaman came. His heart has been on what? Material things. He'll be following that. The challenge. We have that challenge. We have that challenge. Like, let's go back to the slide so that we can tidy it up. One more verse on the same test. One more verse. So as we see the challenge of who one choose to be with. Please, let me say something here before I move to the last one here. Please, who have you been following? You know, these days, there are ways to follow people now. A lot of people are following people online, on social media. Who are you following? When you finish following them, when your pastor is preaching on the altar, what he's saying looks strange. In your heart, there's a disconnect now. There's now a disconnect. You are there physically, but there's a disconnect. You are not following him. You are following them on social media. So you have the challenge of who people are following. The last one, rivalry among followers that affect one's capacity to follow. That is to say, about 10 of us or 3 of us are following the same person. Are you listening to me? But rivalry, like he explained to us with, Matthew just now. But let's look at this one. John 21, 20 to 20. 20 to 21. Just those two verses. Rivalry, this include, we're talking about, contention and the rest. Look at this. In this same text, it says same text. By this time, Jesus came. When he came, he gave them food in that same John 21, after giving them food and all of that, because Jesus had to come back because he can see. I believe that when Jesus saw Peter with Didymus and Nathanael, Jesus came back to stay with Peter a bit. If there can be a connection, because Peter had been disconnected. He has gone to heaven, no? He has to come back. He has to come back. The man I handed everything to has been with Thomas Didymus. Lord, give me permission. Let me go back on a rescue mission. Today, anyone that needs to be rescued, you shall be rescued tonight. So, they are trying to resuscitate him. That's Peter now. Now, let's look at the same text. Look at the text. Then Peter turning about. Look at this. See the disciple whom Jesus loved following. He saw John following. Look at what he said. Which also leaned on his breast at supper and said, Lord, which is he that betrayed thee? When he saw John following, look at the kind of question he's now asking Jesus. Don't forget I talk about rivalry. Are you hearing me? 3 of us are following, 10 of us are following. Instead of you to follow, there is enough for everybody. Now, he brought the issue, the allegation about who betrayed Jesus that everybody knew. He brought the matter on the top runner, brought it up. As if John was part of that arrangement. Go to the next verse. That was fair. Allegation one. Then there's another one. Then Peter seeing him, said to the Lord, look at this. And what shall this man do? That is to say, you see this man? He will commit. Oh, he will commit from the way I'm looking at him. Look at Jesus' response.
Jesus said unto him, if I will that he tarry till I come, what is that to thee? Follow thou me. Three people here. Three people come. Three come. Pastor, please come. Yes. Stay like this. He's our Oga. Face this side. Face this side. He is the man we have come to. Are you listening to me? Both of them are following. If you see where John ended and where Jesus ended, you know that they had different tea altogether that they drew from the Lord Jesus. He saw him following. Then he started raising allegations. My brother, you don't need to pull somebody down to draw from the leader. The reason why you are having a disconnect is because Pastor Nob is following. And you are thinking that Pastor Nob is following, is occupy all the space. There is nothing for me again. Jesus said, my friend, what does that consign you? Follow me. I still have enough for you. Thank you, sir. Rivalry. A lot of things going on in your mind. Because you can say, yeah, they prefer him more than me. No. Do you know about the riches of the kingdom? It's inexhaustible. Look at your face. Look at another person's face. And the grace, what you came to do and what she came to do, they are different. Follow your leader. Follow your pastor. Make sure there's a connection and take your own. Stop looking at somebody else. He brought allegation of his betrayer that happened before the man went. Jesus was watching. Then he looked at him again. From the way I'm looking at this man will commit. Oh, say, follow me. Let's finish. Go to the slide. Let's just finish. Let's round up. Let's finish. Next one. Conclusion. To be with me, the be with me followership skill is what is needed by many followers to be able to get all they need from their leader and to become what they want to be. Stay with a heart connection. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. So also it's important to state that all those examined to have demonstrated the be with me followership skill all became made or had their work status changed. Therefore, the be with me followership skill is a must for all followers who desire to become great leaders like their mentors. All right? Last one. Thank you. Pastor David, please permit me. The Lord, when I was praying, told me, there are many of us here, we have disconnected from the person that is you are supposed to draw from. Either your departmental head, the pastor in charge of your branch or wherever, or even the man of God that is here. There need to be a reconnection. I want us to rise up. I felt very led in my spirit that there must be a reconnection tonight. And if you feel that you need God's help, because how do you want to spend 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 10 years, and you live with nothing? If you are there, come out. I'm going to invite Pastor Dave to come back, to come here and pray. If you are there, come here. There must be a connection. There must be a connection. You disconnected. How can you then be discipled? Come out quickly. Just come out. You know, while they sing, come out. You know, man of God, please come. You know, come out. Don't look at anybody. This is about you, about your destiny. You disconnected over issues because you met Didymus. Thomas, because you met Nathaniel. Come. Wherever you are, keep coming.